Good morning, students. Welcome back to your SST class. And today we will start chapter number 6, Food We Eat. Okay. So, what is the traditional food of the place you belong to? Find out from your parents about when and how it is prepared. Okay. And also find out why it is prepared on the occasion. You can then speak about it in the class. Okay. So, let's start. India is a vast country with varied physical features. So, India is a vast country with various types of physical features. Some places are hot while some are cool. Some places are hot, some are cold. Okay. Some places receive less rainfall, while others receive heavy rainfall. Due to these differences in climate and landforms, different types of crops are grown at different places by the farmers. So, according to the climate and the landform, the farmers grow different types of crops depending on that area. Okay. Thus, people living in different parts of India have different food habits. So, people living in hot places, people living in cool places, people living in the areas where there is less rainfall, the areas where there is heavy rainfall. So, they have different kinds of food habits, okay, according to the climate of that place and the landform. So, food in different parts of India. Food eaten by people is different in different parts of India. Different food items represent the lifestyle and culture of the people. So, food eaten by people is different in different parts of India. Okay. So, different food items represent the lifestyle and culture of the people. According to the food items, you can find out the lifestyle and culture of the people. People in North India eat more rotis and parathas that are made from wheat than South India, where people prefer to eat more rice. People belonging to North India, they prefer to eat more rotis and parathas that are made from wheat, whereas the people belonging to South India, they prefer to eat more rice. In coastal states such as Goa, Kerala and West Bengal, people eat a lot of fish. In the coastal states such as Goa, Kerala and West Bengal, people, they like to eat a lot of fish. People who live in the mountains and on plains eat more of chicken and mutton than fish. So, people who are living in the mountain areas, who are living on the plains, they prefer to eat chicken and mutton than fish. Indian food is one of the most relished cuisines in the world. So, Indian food is one of the most relished means enjoy greatly. Cuisines means methods of cooking. So, in India, you will find various kinds of dishes. Okay. And people enjoy. So Indian food is one of the most relished cuisines in the world. Indians use a variety of cooking oils such as ghee, that is butter oil, groundnut oil, sunflower oil and mustard oil to prepare food. So, Indians use variety of oils such as ghee, that is called butter oil also, groundnut oil, sunflower oil, mustard oil to prepare food. Spices such as cloves, cinnamon, ginger, cardamom, pepper, turmeric, herbs, etc. are used to make Indian dishes tasty. So, spices are used to make the Indian dishes tasty. So, these kind of spices, cloves, cinnamon, ginger, cardamom, pepper, turmeric, herb, you can see all these in this picture. These are spices of India. Okay. Now, let us move on to next page. That is page number 42. Addition of onion, garlic, chilies, coriander, saffron and curry leaves increases flavor and taste of our food. So when we add onion, garlic, chilies, coriander, saffron, curry leaves, this increases the flavor and taste of our food. In villages, many people use cow dung cakes as fuel to cook food on a chulha. In towns and cities, people use gas stoves, microwaves, etc. for cooking. So in villages, you find chulhas for cooking. People use chulhas for cooking. Okay, they use the cow dung cake as fuel. In towns and cities, people use gas stoves, microwaves for cooking. You can see the chulha here. A woman cooking food on a chulha. Cooking on chulhas consume a lot of fuel and also pollute the environment. Food being cooked on a gas stove. So one information is given, let us see. A blue flame of the burner indicates proper burning of gas, while yellow flame indicates blockage in the burner which needs to be corrected. When you see the blue flame of the burner, it indicates that it is properly burning. Okay. But when you find the flame is yellow in color, this indicates that there is blockage in the burner and which needs to be corrected. Identify the following spices. Find out their names in English and in your mother tongue. You already know these spices. See the picture and find out the names in English and as well as in your mother tongue what these spices are known. You will find this in your kitchen itself. Food in North India. Mughal kings ruled over North India in the past. They were fond of delicious food. Hence, Mughlai dishes became popular in North India. So, Mughal kings, they ruled over North India in the past. They were fond of delicious food. So, Mughlai dishes became popular in North India. Okay. Next, people in Kashmir eat different dishes along with rice. Saag, a green gravy is prepared with a green leafy vegetable known as hak. So, people who live in Kashmir, they eat different dishes along with rice. Okay. Saag is what? A green gravy is prepared with a green leafy vegetable known as hak. So, saag is known in Kashmir as hak. The dishes that are made with saag is known as hak. So, in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh, wheat is the staple food of people. Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, which is the staple food of people? Wheat. Okay. They make breads called chapatis or rotis, rumali roti, tandoori roti and naan from flours of wheat, corn or maida. So, the people living in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh, wheat is their staple food. They make breads called chapatis, rotis, rumali roti, tandoori roti, naan from the flours of wheat, corn or maida. Okay, this is their main food, wheat. So, here we end our class today. In the next part, we will complete the whole chapter. Till then, you will read the chapter. You will try to understand it. You will find this name of spices. Okay. So, till then, take care, bye and thank you, children.